Our topic is complex power series. First of all, we have to discuss definition of power series. For any complex number Z, a series of the form summation n equals to 0 to infinity an into z minus z naught whole power n equals to a naught plus a1 into z minus z naught plus a2 into z minus z naught whole square plus and so on plus an into z minus z naught whole power n plus and so on. Where a0 comma a1 comma a2 comma and so on an are constants. This is known as power series in powers of z minus z0. Here z naught is called the center of the power series. This is also called the power series in powers of z. In powers of z minus z naught, about the point z naught. This is the definition of power series. If z naught equals to 0, then a series summation n equals to 0 to infinity an into z power n is called the power series in powers of z only. In powers of z. Next definition is radius of convergence. Radius of convergence. If summation n equals 0 to infinity an into z power n, it is converges for modulus of z less than capital R and diverges for modulus of z greater than R, then capital R is called the radius of convergence of the power series and modulus of z equals to capital R is called the circle of the convergence of the power series. Next theorem is Pellard's theorem. First of all, I have to discuss statement of Pellard's theorem. If f of z is analytic inside a circle C with the center A and radius small r, let z be any point inside C, then f of z equals to f of a plus z minus a by 1 factorial z minus a by 1 factorial in the f dash of a plus z minus a whole square by 2 factorial into f double dash of a plus and so on plus z minus a whole power n by n factorial into n dash of a plus and so on. This is known as Pellard series expansion of f of z about the point z equals to a or in powers of z minus a. I will leave it once again. Statement of Pellard's theorem. If f of z is analytic inside a circle C with center A and radius small r, let z be any point inside C, then f of z equals to f of a plus z minus a by 1 factor in the f dash of a plus z minus a whole square divided by 2 factor in the f double dash of a plus and so on plus z minus a whole power n by n factor into n dash of a. This is known as Pellard series expansion of f of z above z equals to a over r in powers of z minus a. Next topic is Maclaurin series. By putting a equals to 0 in Pellard series, we get the Maclaurin series. There is nothing but f of z equals to f of 0 plus z by 1 factorial into f dash of 0 plus z square by 2 factorial into f double dash of 0 plus and so on plus z power n by n factorial into n dash of 0 plus and so on. This is known as Maclaurin series about the point z equals to 0. You are in powers of z only. Some standard expansions in binomial theorem is if modulus of x less than 1, then 1 plus x whole power minus 1 equals to 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus x power 4 minus and so on. Second point is 1 minus x whole power minus 1 equals to 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube plus x power 4 plus and so on. Third form is 1 plus x whole power minus 2 equals to 1 minus 3x plus 3x square minus 4x cube plus and so on. 1 minus x whole power minus 2 equals to 1 plus 3x plus 3x square plus 4x cube plus and so on. These are three binomial expansions. Next problem on Taylor series. Obtain the Taylor series expansion of f of z equals to sin z about the point z equals to pi by 2. That means find the Taylor series expansion of f of z equals sin z about the point z equals to pi by 2. The solution of this problem is given that f of z equals to sin z. The Taylor series expansion of f of z about z equals to a is given by f of z equals to f of a plus z minus a by 1 factorial into f dash of a plus z minus a whole square by 2 factorial into f double dash of a plus z minus a whole cube by 3 factorial into f triple dash of a plus and so on. Here a value equals to, according to the given data, a value equals to pi by 2. Therefore, f of z equals to f of pi by 2 plus z minus pi by 2 by 1 factorial into f dash of pi by 2 plus z minus pi by 2 whole square by 2 factorial into f double dash of pi by 2 plus z minus pi by 2 whole cube by 3 factorial into f triple dash of pi by 2 plus and so on. Called as equation 2. Now, f of z equals to sin z. Differentiate this result with respect to z. F dash of z equals to cos z. F double dash of z equals to minus sin z. Differentiation of sin z equals to cos z. Differentiation value of cos z equals to minus sin z. F triple dash of z equals to minus cos z. That implies f of pi by 2 equals to sin pi by 2. Sin pi by 2 value is nothing but 1. F dash of pi by 2 equals to cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 value is nothing but 0. F double dash of pi by 2 equals, that means minus sin pi by 2 means minus 1. F triple dash of pi by 2 equals to minus cos pi by 2 equals to cos pi by 2 value is nothing but 0. Like substitute these values in equation 2, we get a f of z equals to f of pi by 2 is nothing but 1 plus z minus pi by 2 by 1 factorial into f dash of pi by 2 is nothing but 0 into 0 plus z minus pi by 2 whole square by 2 factorial into f double dash of pi by 2 equals to minus 1 plus z minus pi by 2 whole cube by 3 factorial into f triple dash of pi by 2 equals to 0 plus and so on. Therefore, f of z is nothing but sin z equals to 1 minus z minus pi by 2 whole square by 2 factorial minus z minus 1 minus z minus pi by 2 whole square by 2 factorial plus z minus pi by 2 whole power 4 by 4 factorial
minus z minus 5 by 2 whole power 6 by 6 factorial plus and so on.
This is known as the Taylor series expansion of sin z about z equals to 5 by 2.
Problem in Taylor series is
find the Taylor series of z minus 1 by z plus 1 about z equals to 1. Solution of this problem is that f of z equals to z minus 1 by z plus 1. Here, derivatives of the given function. Here, derivatives of the given function are difficult, so we use another method to expand Taylor series of f of z of the given function. That we expand f of z above z equals to 1. That means the Taylor series of f of z in powers of z minus 1. That is in powers of z minus 1. So we have to put that z minus 1 equals to w. That equals to z equals to 1 plus w. Substitute the z value in f of z. Therefore, f of z equals to 1 plus w minus 1 divided by 1 plus w plus 1. That implies plus 1 minus 1 is cancel the numerator w by 2 plus w. In Taylor series, in the denominator, we can take the constant term as common to get the form of 1 plus or minus pi of z. Because we have positive powers of z minus a in Taylor series. So that's why the denominator common as constant term, that is w divided by 2 into 1 plus w by 2. That equals to, this value can be written as, take the denominator term to the numerator, that value can be written as 1 plus w by 2 whole power minus 1. Since 1 plus x whole power minus 1 equals to 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus and so on, if modulus of x less than 1. So this is the binomial expansion. So we have to use same expansion. This is that equals to w by 2 into 1 minus w by 2 plus w by 2 whole square minus w by 2 whole cube plus and so on. If modulus of w by 2 less than 1. That equals to, since we know w is nothing but z minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus z minus 1 by 2 plus z minus 1 whole square by 4 minus z minus 1 whole cube by 2 cube is nothing but 8 plus and so on. If modulus of z minus 1 less than 1 by 2 is the reason. That equals to z minus 1 by 2 into summation n equals 0 to infinity. Minus 1 whole power n z minus 1 whole power n divided by 2 power n. If modulus of z minus 1 less than 2. That equals to summation n equals to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole power n z minus 1 whole power n plus 1 by 2 power n plus 1. Here 2 into 2 power n. Basis equals and powers are added. We can write by 2 power n plus 1. The reason is modulus of z minus 1 less than 2. This is the value of
f of z.
This is the required Galois expansion of f of z about z equals 1. Third problem is expand e power z as a Maclaurin series about z equals to 0. Let f of z equals to e power z. Since we know that the Maclaurin series of f of z about z equals to 0 is f of z equals to f of 0 plus z by 1 factorial into f dash of 0 plus z square by 2 factorial into f double dash of 0, z cube by 3 factorial into f triple dash of 0 plus and so on. Here, this one is considered as equation 1. Now, f of z equals to e power z. Differentiation this with respect to z, we get f dash of z, e power z. Again, differentiate this with respect to z. D by dz of e power z is e power z. F triple dash of z equals to e power z. That implies f of 0 equals to e power 0 equals to 1. F dash of 0 equals to e power 0 equals to 1. F double dash of 0 equals to e power 0 equals to 1. F triple dash of 0 equals to e power 0 equals to 1. Substituting these values. In equation 1, we get f of z is nothing but e power z, f of 0 is nothing but 1 plus z by 1 factorial into 1 plus z square by 2 factorial into 1 plus z cube by 3 factorial into 1 plus and so on. Therefore, e power z equals to 1 plus z by 1 factorial plus z square by 2 factorial plus z cube by 3 factorial plus and so on, which is known as required Maclaurin series expansion of e power z. Thank you.